your eyes.
Come on.
Close your eyes.
Okay.
Hold out your hand.
What's this?
Happy 3-month anniversary.
What am I, like 6 years old?
You've got a whole pile of stuffed animals in your room.
So, who's getting the movie tonight?
Who usually gets it?
Not Charlie's Angels again.
Come on, Drew Barrymore.
Gary, why don't you go pick up that Adam Sandler movie you wanted to see?
No problem. See you tonight.
Oh, I'll pick up that new CD you wanted.
Cool.
So my house, 7:30? Thanks for the bag, Gary Bear. In front of the other, all I know. But I know when the one thing that keeps me together will get me over. It won't change nothing at all.
Is that what you're looking for?
Tom. Tom!
Where's your trophy, Jack?
Where's your hair, Jarhead? Oh. I missed you.
I don't feed you like that at basic.
More potatoes?
Could do.
And go get your brother seconds.
Tom's old enough to get his own potatoes.
No, honey, I really think you should get them.
He's closer.
Potatoes.
Okay. It came. Mom, you opened it?
Oh. Jackson.
You liar. I got it.
Yeah, they say that you either get beauty or brains. Now we know.
Oh my God. Tara Holt, I gotta tell Gary and Paige
now?
Oh, come on, Mom. Please, please, please.
Your brother just got home.
Let her go. It's okay, Mom.
But don't stay out too late.
Come on, I'm practically in college.
Midnight and not a minute later.
Oh, hey, Dad. Thanks for this new CD.
We are so proud of you, baby.
Thank you. Oh, this rocks.
Is registered to a Don Slotty.
Who?
Slooty, Don Slooty. Ann Sluti is listed as the principal driver. What? Do you know her?
I'll get it. Mike.
No. She went to Paige's house. She left an hour or so ago.
And went to the mall.
She was going to buy a CD.
Did you call Paige?
Elaine, witnesses saw her being forced into an SUV.
Shouldn't have screamed back there. Why'd you do that? Answer me, why'd you scream?
Because you were hitting me.
Now, sit. Go on, sit. Up here.
Sport utility vehicle. Two occupants, Caucasian, female, 17 years old.
For each of the people who stays all alleys and back roads, he is presumed armed and dangerous.
In most abductions, the family is contacted, so we're going to set up here and be ready to trace the call. Dave, I need that at the fax machine.
But is it money? A ransom?
We don't know yet. It's why we need to be ready in case he calls.
So we just wait?
You need to stay put.
And do nothing?
In case the kidnapper calls.
That's just great.
Tom, let's just let them do their job.
Mr. S., what's going on? Where's Ann?
We're gonna have to ask you all some questions.
No problem.
You need to understand it can be intrusive.
Stay still. Stay still.
Don't hurt me. I won't tell anybody. I promise I'm not gonna. I'm not gonna say anything. Please let me go. Don't. Please don't do this.
I'll make you a deal. If you can get the tape off, I'll let you go.
I have to do better than that. Time's almost up.
You lose.
There's a swarm of reporters out there.
The more people who see Ann's face on TV, the more tips we're gonna get. The fewer places this guy's gonna have to hide.
You got Ann's picture. What are we waiting for?
It might not go our way. It could panic the kidnapper. And that's a risk you're gonna have to weigh.
Well, the story's already out there. I mean, it's all over the news. Getting Ann's picture out there will help. We should do it.
Tell us what to do, Mike.
Approximately 5 hours ago, 17-year-old Ann Slutty was abducted from the Hilltop Mall by a unidentified Caucasian male. Ann is 5'7" tall. She has brown hair and blue eyes and is wearing a pink hooded sweatshirt and blue jeans. Now, we're asking all of the residents of Kearney and the surrounding counties to be on the alert and to report any potential sightings of Ann and her abductor to their local police. When they were last seen, they were driving a dark blue Suburban with Louisiana plates.
Detective Timberger, are the FBI involved in this investigation?
Well, if there's any indication that Ann was taken outside of Nebraska, we'll certainly contact the FBI.
The Isn't it true that almost 75% of children kidnapped are murdered within the first 3 hours of abduction?
Well, that depends on a lot of different circumstances.
And isn't it true that after 24 hours, the statistical chances of her being found alive are virtually nil?
Well, that's why we're asking for everybody's help and cooperation in this matter. Okay, that's it, folks. Thank you.
Saved your life. I own you.
This is it. Are we ready?
What do I say?
Just stay calm and try and keep them on the line as long as you can. All right? Ready?
Hello? No, we're not giving any interviews.
They're like jackals.
If I hear or see one more reporter,
I'll deal with it. I'll deal with it.
Yeah, I'm inside the house now. I will ask them. Mrs. Sleedy?
How did you get in here?
Get out of here right now!
You're making a mistake.
Get out of my house!
Hey,
get out of here!
Tom! It's okay. Nerves are a little frazzled around here right now.
I can see that.
This is Agent Reynolds of the FBI.
FBI?
Because the car had Louisiana plates, there's a likelihood that the kidnapper's taken Ann across state lines.
And that makes it a federal investigation.
Then Ann could be anywhere.
Come on, keep up.
You try walking barefoot with bleeding feet.
Builds character.
Bleeding feet?
Pain.
I'm a friend of the family. They're expecting me.
Oh, Elaine.
Appreciate this. We've got to get her out of here.
I just want to help. I don't feel right leaving.
Elaine, don't think about it. You need rest. You've been up for 36 hours. Even a few hours sleep at my house, away from all this, will do you a world of good. Okay.
Thanks, Diane. Yeah.
Okay. I'll look after things here.
It's okay, Mom.
You hungry?
Yeah.
What's your name?
What's your name?
They call me Jack. As in Jackrabbit. I'm fast and I'm strong.
You must work out a lot.
Whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with thy might.
Ecclesiastes.
Very good. You can have another one. Yeah, Grandma insisted on Bible school.
If we confess our sins, then he is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins. But I'm okay. Maybe less trouble that way.
And do what? Call up your house and say, kiss my ass, I have your daughter?
I could say it was my idea. But it doesn't even have to be my parents. I could just call a friend.
Say you were going on vacation.
Yeah, sure.
Turn that off. The sink.
Diane, answer.
What do I say?
Say hello. Act natural. Pick it up. Go ahead.
Hello? Hello?
Hi, is Elaine there?
No, Elaine's not here right now.
Do you know who this is?
Is this Anne?
Yes.
Oh, Anne, where are you?
I'm okay. I'm not hurt or anything.
How did we get you home?
Hopefully. Just tell Elena called.
Are you Anne? Anne!
Did we get the trace?
Not long enough.
Vacation. You're supposed to say vacation.
You hung up before I could say it.
Taking too long.
Call someone else, another friend.
She's alive. Anne's alive. We have to tell Elaine and Dawn.
Of course.
Kat, play that back for me, will you?
Hi, is Elaine there?
No, Elaine's not here right now.
Do you know who this is?
Hear that? Sounds like a lot of highway traffic to me.
Absolutely.
Oh, Anne, where are you?
I'm okay. I'm not hurt or anything.
Listen to her.
Did you hear how carefully she said Elaine?
Kidnapper must have been standing right there.
That's why she didn't ask for Mom. She knew we'd be here. Whatever she's been through, she's keeping her wits about her.
Paige?
Oh my God, Anne! Oh God, you're alive! Where are you? Are you okay?
I'm fine. Don't worry. I'm just, looking for a quality vacation.
Good girl. I guess now we can start our vacation.
Called?
Yes.
Elaine. Jane, she sounded just fine.
What did she say?
She also called Paige. We just got the tape.
You heard her voice?
Do we know her, Annie? Can we go after her?
It's too brief for a trace, but we know that both calls came from a highway payphone. Listen.
For a quality vacation.
Hang on. Let's listen to that last thing she said again really closely.
I'm fine. Don't worry. I'm just, looking for a quality vacation.
Anne didn't say a quality vacation. She said equality vacation.
I'm just, looking for equality vacation.
What does it mean?
Equality. Wyoming is the equality state.
Come on, she's that clever under duress?
Yes, she is.
Alert Wyoming authorities to be on the lookout for our blue Suburban. It's a needle in a haystack.
So where should we go on our vacation? Go to Washington? All those trees up there? Or the desert? Nevada? Or the Yukon? No one would ever find us up there. Always wanted to go to the Yukon. Bunch of the boys were whooping it up in the Malamute Saloon. Kid that handled the music box was hitting a jag-time tune. Back of the bar, in a solo game, sat the dangerous Dan McGrew. And watching his luck was his light of love. A lady that's known as Lou. There's men that somehow just grip your eyes and hold them hard like a spell. Such was he. And he looked to me like a man who lived in hell. With a face most hair and the dreary stare of a dog whose day is done. He watered the green stuff in his glass, and the drops fell, one by one. Have you ever been out in the great alone, when the moon is awful clear, and the icy mountains hemmed you in by the silence you most could hear? And then, on a sudden, the music changed. So soft that you scarce could hear. But you felt that your life had been looted clean of all that you once held dear. That someone had stolen the woman you love. That her love was a devil's lie. That your guts were gone. And the best thing for you was to crawl away and die. It was the crowning cry of a heart's despair. And it thrilled you through and through. I guess I'll make it a spread, monsieur, said the dangerous Dan McGrew.
Even own a black dress.
Get out. And don't slam the door. Perfect. I got it all figured out. I'm gonna go live in the mountains. Live off the land.
It sounds far.
It is far. It's the best part about it. You're not eating your food. Eat it. Eat it! Grandma always said, Tony, eat everything on your plate or you're not going to eat again. This crap is better than what they serve you inside, that's for sure.
Prison?
Yeah.
What were you in for?
I'm not so bad. You'll see.
Thank you for dinner.
Yeah. So I got you a present. Should I put it on you?
No. No.
Put it on the other finger. This goes on the other finger. Yeah. Yeah. Beautiful. I gotta take a piss.
Montana. I need help. I've been kidnapped. Ann Slutty. He says his name is Tony. I don't know his last name. No, I don't know him. I never met him before. He kidnapped me from a mall parking lot in Kearney, Nebraska. Yes. Guns and knives. At some cabin in the woods.
Warrants on a Tony or Anthony, and then cross-reference those with the description of our suspect.
How long until we have somebody at the camp?
We're already there. SWAT team has the place surrounded. Apparently they can hear voices coming from inside.
They're going in, aren't they?
Yes, yes, they are.
You have to save her.
We'll do our best, ma'am.
She left a note.
What do you mean they're not there?
What?
What did you say? They're not there.
But you said...
Yes, I'm sorry. They were there.
You're sorry.
I don't care.
You promised.
Elaine, where did they go?
You promised me you'd get her back.
I'm sorry. I know, but... Sorry,
but you guys heard voices, and you said that she was there.
No, she was there. She even left a note saying they were heading north.
She's in Livingston. We know that, right?
Tom, calm down.
It's not that simple.
No, I don't understand that, but it is that simple. You heard what she said. We head north.
Wait a minute.
We're sitting around here too long.
No.
I can't wait for this stuff to figure it out itself, Dad.
Tom.
No, and I'm not screwing around anymore, Dad. I'm going to go and do it myself.
Tom.
Mike.
I got it.
Tom.
What are we doing here? We're just waiting for phone calls, and Anne is out there. She's in Livingston, and we know she's out there. We're waiting around, and I'm gonna get her back myself.
Tom, you need to calm down.
Calm down. We've been sitting in here for days. This is crazy. We need to go and get her.
What are you doing?
I'm going to get my sister.
We have police for that.
Well, they're not doing a good enough job, are they? Mr. Timber, please, let me go.
This isn't helping your family.
This isn't helping Anne.
You need to be here for your parents.
Get out of my way. What's going on?
I know.
Why did you do that? Huh? Why? Why'd you call the cops? That's it! It's over for you! It's over! I may as well put a bullet in your head right now!
His name is Anthony Stephen Wright, also known as Tony Zappa. Arrested 20 times before the age of 18. And there are outstanding warrants for his arrest on charges of assault and battery, B&E, and Grand Theft Auto. Mike, do you remember that incident last month at the Mall of America?
They shut it down.
Yes, for a manhunt. We've been tracking this guy for 2 months. We finally cornered him at the mall. Had every exit and road in and out of the place totally blocked, and still he escaped. Okay, that's Tony Zappa. That's who we're dealing with. He was raised by his grandmother in St. Paul, Minnesota. I'm sending somebody up there now to talk to her and see what we can learn. In the meantime, I'm going to fly to Montana tonight.
Well, I'm coming with you.
No, I think it's best if you stay here.
He's got to go.
We want Mike there.
I know this girl. I know how she thinks. I can help you. I need to be there.
All right. Jet leaves in half an hour. Please don't be late.
Tony Zappa's grandmother?
Who wants to know?
We need to ask you some questions about Tony.
Not deep enough.
Please don't kill me like this.
How do you want to die?
Please don't.
Keep digging.
Yes, I do.
Why?
Because you lied to me.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. You said we were going north together.
We are.
I trusted you. So dig.
Do it yourself.
You pick that up.
Or what? You're going to kill me anyway?
I'm the one giving the orders around here. Pick it up now.
Yeah, I brought him up. His daddy just kept beating him.
I'm not gonna ask again.
So just get it over with.
He loves his grandma. He's a good Christian boy.
Don't! Tony, please, get off me! Don't! Please! Don't. No, get off me, please, Tony, please! Don't!
Shh.
brush yourself up. Go. Go wash yourself up.
Changed. look nice. I'll be right back. Stay there.
Fanning out across Montana, searching for the Kearney, Nebraska honor roll student who disappeared last Friday. The Saluties appeared in public for the first time today to address the kidnapper.
Whoever you are, we will do anything we can to bring Anne home. Please let her go. Anne, I love you. I miss you.
Mom.
What was that?
What?
I heard something.
Zappa is known to the FBI as the Jackrabbit for his uncanny ability to escape a series of police dragnets set up across the central United States. Zappa allegedly kidnapped Saluti from the Hilltop Mall.
Did you see that? I'm the Jackrabbit.
He was last seen driving a stolen suburban SUV with Louisiana license plates.
We need a new car.
Go.
Why?
We need another car. Come on.
No, I mean, why did you take me?
I got tired of being alone.
Pack up the thing. Bring it with us.
We've got a positive on the Suburban.
Where?
All right, so the Suburban was stolen in Louisiana from a Frank Bartlett. The guy was 80 years old and an ex-cop.
Uh-huh.
Zappa beat him up when he stole the car. Frank died 2 days later.
Jeez. Take a look at this. We're not far behind.
Get down! Get down!
Look up there. You see anything? Do you see anything?
No, it's too dark.
You're lying to me.
No.
Don't lie to me.
Delta team in position. Secure the perimeter.
Location secured. Over.
God. Oh, God.
Hold your fire. It's the girl.
This is all your fault. This is all your fault. Red Claw.
I do not have a clean shot. Repeat. No shot.
Let's just call 911 and talk to them.
No, they don't want to talk. They want to kill me.
It's all right. They want us alive. It's gonna be okay.
He's got the girl at gunpoint.
How much separation between them?
About 3 feet.
Have you tied into the phone yet?
Yeah. Calls from the cabin will come directly here.
I'm not going back to prison.
No, I'm gonna tell them that. Okay, I'm gonna tell them.
Bingo. Be careful what you say.
Tony Zappa?
No. It's me.
It's not Zappa. It's Anne. She's the one making the call.
What?
I know. This is a new one. The hostage making the call.
Let me talk to her.
Mike, this is an FBI case.
I know her. It's why you brought me here, right?
Okay. Careful not to reveal that you know her in case Zappa is listening in, okay?
This is Mike Tenbrook. I'm here with the police.
Hi, this is Anne.
Anne, are you okay?
Yes, I'm fine.
Does Tony want to talk to me?
I'm not sure. He wants to speak to you.
No, I don't want to talk to them. It's a trick. They want to get me in front of the window so they can shoot me.
No.
Anne? Anne?
I'm here.
Anne, we're here to find a solution that works for everybody.
Tell Tony that nobody's gonna shoot anybody as long as he cooperates.
Okay. I'll try. Hold on. They want you to cooperate.
Not cooperate. That's what Grandma said. Tony, do what you're told. Do what you're
told, Tony.
What do you think your grandma would say to you right now?
Anne, are you there?
Tony wants to call his grandma.
Okay. Give us a minute, and we'll put the call through.
What do you think you're doing? This is not FBI procedure.
Every minute that boy is on the phone, Anne's still alive.
I'm gonna kill her. And then I'm gonna shoot myself. I'm gonna put the gun in my chest.
And I'm gonna kill myself.
Don't talk nonsense.
Assault teams, go to ready condition. Promise me you're not gonna hurt him. If they shoot, they gotta shoot both of us.
You two need to come out of there now!
It's okay.
Put your guns down!
Tony! Listen to me. I promise you, nobody's gonna shoot you, but you've got about 20 seconds before the FBI comes in there hard, and I'm not gonna be able to stop them.
If I come out there, you're gonna shoot me!
Tony, nobody's gonna shoot you!
Put your guns down!
You need to toss away that gun and lie down on the ground.
I'm putting my gun down. Don't shoot me. Don't shoot me.
You look fantastic.
Thank God.
Hey, I have something of yours. Did you leave this someplace, kiddo? Huh? Let's go home, huh? Yeah? Yeah.